Do Get Stoked Online!
Hi, Mr. Prince!
Hi, Miss Joyce!
Apa kabar? Miss,
bye! Miss, hari ini
yeah, yeah.
Berapa ya, Miss, ya?
This is the...
Kayaknya lama, ya?
First week.
Oh, iya. Yeah. So, the fifth week berarti the last week of our new series called Mighty Moms!
Yes, we've been talking about some amazing moms for the past 4 weeks.
Hmm.
You still remember the names of the last 4 mothers we talk about?
Yeah, I remember.
Really? Kids di rumah, kalian ingat gak siapa namanya? Uh-huh. Coba siapa? The first one we talking about?
Yeah, itu benar tuh, Miss.
Sarah! And then, Jacobel.
Hannah, and
Lady Shenamai.
Lady Shenamai yang gak ada namanya itu ya, last week ya?
Iya, jadi dia Lady from Shenam. That's why we call her Lady Shenamai.
Okay.
Nah, we have one more mighty mom to introduce to you today. And her name is Naomi.
Ah, Naomi, the mother-in-law of Ruth.
Yes, right.
Uh-huh.
So, Mr. Prince, aku yakin deh mereka semua udah excited about the lesson. But I think they even more excited about
the games. Yeah, I'm so excited too, Miss, to play the game. Yeah. Hari apa nih, Miss?
Okay, jadi games kita hari ini adalah Balloon Race.
Oh, Balloon Race. I'm very excited.
Sure, it's very excited. Jadi kids, yuk kita lihat gamesnya.
Hi everyone, so today's lesson is about Ruth and Naomi. Even though it was a hard season for them, they stuck together. So like our game today, these two are gonna be stuck together to deliver the ball on a skateboard. So let's watch them. Ready, guys?
Yeah.
Go. Good job, guys. Now switch. It's another pair that has to stick together to deliver the ball on a skateboard. Let's go. Just like Naomi and Ruth, they stuck together. These two are sticking to deliver the ball. Let's go, guys.
Wow, it was a hard game, tapi fun.
Yeah, yeah, benar, Miss. And they did so well. Mereka bersama-sama untuk bisa bawa balon itu, and they did successfully deliver.
Yes, good job, kids. Jadi our story for today is about Naomi and her daughter-in-law, Ruth. Naomi and Ruth decided to stick together during a very hard times in their lives.
And we will learn about this later. Sebelum itu kita harus memuji dan menyembah Tuhan dulu. Tapi sebelum itu kita berdoa.
Oke.
Okay. Tuhan Yesus, saat ini kami berdoa, kami ingin mendengarkan lesson about Mami Naomi, Tuhan, dan ajari setiap kami supaya kami mengerti bahwa Engkau membuat segala sesuatunya mungkin, Tuhan, untuk kami di dalam nama Tuhan Yesus. Amin.
Amin. God is over the moon. He's crazy about you. His love is so true. God is over the moon. God is over the moon. He's crazy about you. His love is so true. God is over the moon. And if you wanna know she loves you so, just open up your eyes. And if you wanna see how awesome it can be, then open up your heart and soul and mind. And admit to God you're a sinner.
Dearest Mother Naomi, please permit me to write to you in the midst of all that God is doing. It almost overwhelms me. You would think it enough that the Lord sustained us after such a tragedy to strike. So far from your home, for us to lose all the men in our family, father and your sons, one of whom was, of course, my husband. Or how he protected us on our way back to your hometown. And then to lead us to Boaz, your relative, my redeemer, and now my husband. As I think about these things, I still can't get over how, even in your grief and sorrow, you would still accept my company. Remember, you even changed your name to Mara, meaning bitter? But you were faithful to what little family you had left. You didn't turn me away. More than anything else, that selfless, kind, and faithful love made me commit to being with you, making your people, making your God my God. And now, our Lord has blessed us with a child, Obed. May I confess to you, O Mother, as being a bit bewildered. Boaz and I have that sense that our children and their children to come are special. I'm sure you would tell us that's all part of the awesome plan God has for us and for our people. Your faith in God always amazes me. Always yours as you are always mine. Ruth.
Today we are going to talk about Naomi. Naomi was the wife of a man named Elimelech. They had two sons, and their names were Mahlon and Chilion. When there was a great famine in Judah, Naomi and her family decided to move to a far away place named Moab. The family stayed in Moab for a while, and Naomi's husband passed away there. When Naomi's sons were ready to marry, they chose two Moabite women named Orpah and Ruth. Years after they got married, both of Naomi's sons died, leaving Orpah and Ruth as widows. Naomi was heartbroken. Her husband had passed away, and now she also lost both her sons. She did not have anything left to her name. So she decided to go back to her hometown in Judah.
Ya. Kids, kita lihat ceritanya dari Bible dulu ya. Let's see in Bible Ruth 1, verse 6 to 7. When Naomi heard in Moab that the Lord had come to the aid of his people by providing food for them, she and her daughters-in-law prepared to return home from there. With her two daughters-in-law, she left the place where she had been living and set out on the road that would take them back to the land of Judah. Jadi, soon after they left their house, Naomi kept thinking about what would happen to her daughters-in-law if she brought them home to Judah. She thought that nobody from Judah would want to marry foreigners from Moab. She feared that their futures would be ruined if she brought them home to Judah. So, she urged them to go home to their families in Moab, where they can have a chance at a better future.
Mm-hmm.
Jadi Naomi bilang sama Orpah dan sama Ruth, udah Orpah, Ruth, kamu pulang gi, pulang ke rumah papa mama kamu, gitu.
Karena mami Naomi mau pulang ke Judah,
yeah.
Berpikir mungkin nggak ada apa orang Judah nggak ada yang mau nikahi orang Moab ya.
Nah, after a little convincing, Orpah agreed with her mother-in-law and went back to her family.
Nah, terus Ruth gimana?
Nah, however, Ruth, she want to stick with Naomi forever.
Okay, I see. So, let's continue in Ruth chapter 1, verse 16 to 18. But Ruth replied, "Do not urge me to leave you or to turn back from you. Where you go, I will go. And where you stay, I will stay. Your people will be my people and your God, my God. Where you die, I will die, and there I will be buried. May the Lord deal with me, be it ever so severely, if even death separates you and me." When Naomi realized that Ruth was determined to go with her, she stopped urging her. So, Naomi and Ruth traveled back to Naomi's hometown in Judah. It was there where they met a man named Boaz, who eventually became Ruth's husband and even took care of Naomi. Well, you can read the whole story in the Bible later. And there's one thing we can learn from the story today.
What is that, Mr. Cruz?
The lesson that we can learn from today is God is moving even when we cannot see it.
Wow, that's great.
Say it together.
Okay.
God is moving even when we cannot see it.
Jadi, apa maksudnya God is moving in the story of Naomi?
The whole book of Ruth is a story about regular people going through life, experiencing survival, loss, pain, happiness, hope, and joy. Just like us, Ruth and Naomi have their ups and downs. Sometimes it is easy to forget that God is working and moving in our lives, especially when we face troubles and hardship. As the saying goes, if you cannot see God's hand, trust His heart. But as we see in the scripture, even if Naomi and Ruth were just trying to survive and get through the next day, God had bigger plans for them.
Oh, can you write this sentence? Jadi we can see that the Bible tell us that Ruth and Boaz had a child named Obed.
Obed.
The father of?
Jesse.
Jesse, whose son was King David. Little did Naomi know that her daughter-in-law would be the great-grandmother of the most powerful king in Israel and the ancestor of?
The Messiah.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah, and Naomi initially thought that her life was over. Pikir, udah deh, hidupku udah nothing gitu ya. And the future ahead of her was very sad and difficult. But in her pain, she continued to take care of her daughter-in-law. Dan coba untuk mencarikan suami yang bisa menjaga Ruth. God answered her prayers and brought Ruth and Boaz together. Naomi was basically Ruth's mother, and through her, God showed marriage, faithfulness, and love.
Wow, such a wonderful story. God also gives us a taste of His faithfulness through our mothers or mother figures. Who much like Naomi was to Ruth. Mungkin mami kita atau figur mami kita, they are not perfect. But they do all they can do to take care of us. So one more time before we end this series, kids, go and give your mom or mother figure a hug and thank her for loving and caring for you. Come on, go, hug your mom. Figurnya Miss Post dulu,
Okay,
let's go. So share kids to express your love to your moms or your mother figures. Just like our quote truth, masih inget gak?
Yeah, masih. Okay. Our quote truth says, God also expresses His love through mothers. Giliran Miss?
God also expresses His love through mothers. And the power verse in Isaiah 49 verse 15. The Lord answers, can a woman forget the baby she nurses? Can she feel no kindness for the child she gave birth to? Even if she could forget her children, I will not forget you, says the Lord.
Let's take a look.
Power
first time.
Forget the baby she nurses. Can she feel no kindness for the child she gave birth to? Even if she could forget, even if she could forget her children.
The culture in the area of Israel long ago, that women did not have the means to care for themselves.
Oh, gitu?
So if they did not have a husband or a son, their life was as good as over, kayak hidupnya kayak mudah gitu.
Nothing gitu.
Iya, betul. But God provided a way to care for them. by giving a law that stated that close relatives need to take care or save their widows. This is what called a kinsman redeemer.
Nah, jadi Boaz itu berarti dia kinsman redeemer-nya Naomi. Jadi Boaz is a picture of what Jesus is to us.
Yes.
Jesus is our kinsman redeemer. He had to be born and human, so he would be our relative, giving him the right to redeem or save us. Isn't it great?
Yeah.
That's what Jesus did for
Amen.
Us. So, okay kids, kita doa dulu ya sebelum kita selesai. Dear Jesus, terima kasih Tuhan karena Engkau mau lahir ke dunia sebagai manusia. Engkau bersedia turun, Bapak. Engkau bersedia mati di kayu salib, Tuhan. Sehingga Engkau bisa menebus kami. Dan kami bisa di take care oleh Engkau, ya Bapak. Terima kasih Tuhan. Ajar kami juga untuk bisa take care orang-orang yang ada di sekeliling kami. Orang tua kami, teman-teman kami, kakak adik kami. Ajar kami untuk punya hati yang seperti Engkau, ya Tuhan Yesus. Terima kasih Bapak, dalam nama Tuhan Yesus kami berdoa. Amin.
Amin. Okay. Yes.
Our last lesson
for the series Mighty Mom. Tapi kalian jangan khawatir karena minggu depan kita akan masuk new series dan topiknya
jangan disebutin supaya kids penasaran.
Okay.
So kids, you have to stay tuned again next week. Jangan kemana-mana.
Okay, and stay tuned. See you again next week in brand new series.
Yes.
Bye.